Hello, everybody. Andrea Majeski here. So let's talk about teeth whitening. This is a very popular topic lately. Let's talk about teeth whitening and is it safe? And what different types of options do you have? So I'm holding up a couple different things here. Now I'm going to go through teeth whitening options that you can get professionally done in a dental office and then take home kits that you can get as well. Now to get it professionally done, that is the best way to do it because a professional is doing it for you. Not all teeth are the same. It's like hair color. You can get a box dye from the store, but it doesn't always turn out how you want it to. So it's the same thing with teeth whitening. If you go to purchase an over-the-counter teeth whitening product, it might not be right for your teeth. It might not be right for your enamel. It might not be right for your shade. You have probably heard a lot of horror stories of people being very, very sensitive having an over-the-counter teeth whitening product, because with a professional we have different types of peroxides mixed in, and we mix in different types depending on your current shade and depending on the health of your enamel. Some people's teeth, they are very, very thin, so they have thin enamel. They would use a different type of composition than somebody who has very thick enamel and doesn't need to go too many shades lighter. So there is definitely a difference. So the best thing to do is to get it done by a dental professional, and you can get quite light. But if you wanted, say, over-the-counter products, believe it or not, there are professional over-the-counter products as well. So I like this one. This is the one that I give to my patients, and this is the one that I teach to my students in my teeth whitening course, where I teach people how to have their own teeth whitening business. I like this one because it has the right mix of carbamide peroxide and hydrogen peroxide, and it will not make the teeth super sensitive. If you have sensitive teeth currently, I do suggest using a sensitive toothpaste a couple weeks prior. So a couple weeks prior to even using a professional teeth whitening service or an at-home kit, because that will just help to coat the teeth and protect the teeth from any additional sensitivity. Because as soon as you put any type of peroxides on them, if the teeth aren't coated with a proper toothpaste, if needed, it can make things more sensitive. So this is where a dental professional can come in and look at your teeth and tell you if you need a stronger type of desensitizing toothpaste. You can purchase them in store, but then there's also some that you can only get through a dental professional if you really need like a high quality desensitizing toothpaste. So different things to think about too. But I like this one as my over-the-counter product. I mean, not over-the-counter product because you can only get it from a dental professional, but something to use at home. So this includes a tray. It includes a couple syringes, not these ones. This is just an example, but it does include syringes that you put in the tray, put them in your mouth for 15 minutes, 30 minutes, however you want to. It does include a light with it, and the light turns off after 15 minutes. So if you just sort of wanted a quick boost, then it lasts for 15 minutes, or turn it on again for a half an hour. I tell my patients that if they're going to get teeth whitening professionally done, it's still a good idea to upkeep it at home if they want to and use an at-home product that actually works. So a patient might have their teeth whitened with me tomorrow. I will suggest a take-home product that they can boost their whitening in, you know, 2 months or whenever they feel they need that boost. But the right products make all the difference. There are products out there that don't have a desensitizer built in, or there's also products out there that only have one type of peroxide and not two. Hydrogen peroxide does help to lighten the teeth, but carbamide peroxide helps it to last and helps it to kind of form a thin protective barrier over the teeth, so it's a lot harder to get stained. So if this sounds overwhelming to you, which it can be, talk to your dental professional and they can let you know of the different options. Other options that I have too, to just sort of upkeep the whitening at home, there are mouthwashes, There are toothpaste, like there's all kinds of different ones. Like you don't have to get a certain kind, but this is where your dental professional comes in handy because there are different things we can help you with to help to limit stain as much as possible, but also to keep the teeth as healthy as possible. If the teeth are thin, if you are getting a lot of cavities, if you brush too hard, if there's gingival disease in certain areas, your teeth aren't as healthy as they could be. And that's where a mouthwash, toothpaste, even using a different toothbrush can make a big, big difference. So let me know, you guys, if you have any questions. Thank you so much, and I will see you very soon.